Hello, this is the second part of the practical session for the master course AI4Omics Data Integration. This second task proposes you to create a logistic regression model for colon cancer diagnosis. The goal is the same as in the first task, which is to train a machine learning classification model to recognize colon cancer from RNA-seq data. I open a Jupyter notebook with a second task. At the beginning, you are invited to execute the code that we have already used in the first part. We first import several packages that we will need. We then define a function, calculate accuracy, to train the model and to calculate its accuracy. Finally, we import the data with the expression levels of 60 genes in colon samples. There are normal and tumor samples in the data. Our goal is to predict the targets, normal or tumoral class, containing in the column tissue status. For a machine learning pipeline, we create a list of targets, Y, as a separate object. The first question, create a data frame X, including all the available features. It means that we need to use all the 60 genes. In the original data, we have 61 columns, 60 columns with the expression levels, and one column tissue status. We need to extract 60 columns corresponding to the genes and to create a separate data frame X. There are several ways to do this. For example, we can extract only the columns of numerical types using the method selectDTypesNumber. In this case, the column tissue status, which contains textual labels, will be excluded and we keep only the expression levels of the 60 genes. Another possibility would be to drop the column tissue status. Question 2. Create training and test datasets of 4 folds using 3 folds for the trained dataset and 1 fold for the test dataset. The code is already given. We use the module train-test-split. You need to indicate here the size of the test dataset, which should be 1/4. Implicitly, it means that the other 3/4 of samples will be used for the training dataset. We created the training dataset X-train, the test dataset X-test, and the corresponding targets Y-train and Y-test. How many samples contain the obtained training and test datasets? You can complete the code with the attribute shape for each data frame. In the training dataset, we have 603 samples. In the test dataset, 201 samples. Question 3. Perform a standardization of data. Data standardization is an important step in the machine learning pipeline to improve the performance of algorithms. Data standardization is a feature scaling technique that converts original data, where multiple features can be spanning different ranges and degrees of magnitude, into a comparable range of values. In our example, we work with the gene expression levels. The magnitude of expression levels can be substantially different between different genes. To facilitate the learning process, we usually scale the data before training. The most common standardization technique is Z-score or standard score, where the values are centered around the mean with a unit standard deviation. The mean and standard deviation are calculated on the training dataset only and then applied to both training and test datasets. The test dataset should never be used in the learning process, even during the step of data scaling. The calculations should be performed on the training dataset. In scikit-learn, data standardization can be realized with a standard scalar object. In the exercise, you need to execute the following code. First, we import the standard scalar module. We then create an instance of the standard scalar. The method fit calculates the mean mu and the standard deviation sigma using the training dataset only, X-train. The calculated values mu and sigma are stored in the scalar object. In the next line of code, you can display the mean values mu for each feature. For 60 genes, we obtain 60 mean values. The mean values are different for each gene. We can also display the standard deviation sigma for each gene. A standardization consists to remove the mean from each expression value and then to divide the result by the standard deviation. These two operations are executed when we apply the transform method of the scalar on xtrain. The method returns a scaled matrix that I name it xtrain scaled. The next line converts xtrain scaled from NumPy format into a pandas data frame for our convenience. The training dataset is scaled. Now you are invited to write the code to scale the test dataset xtest. As you remember, we should apply to the test dataset the means and standard deviations calculated on the training dataset. Therefore, for the test dataset, we execute directly the method transform without the fit method. We obtain xtest scaled and convert it into a pandas data frame. After the standardization, the mean values of expression levels should be equal to 0 for all genes in xtrain scaled, and the standard deviation should be equal to 1. Check that the mean values are zeros for the first 5 features in xtrain scaled. Here we need to calculate the mean for the features in xtrain scaled, and then we can display the first 5 rows with the method head. The values are not exactly zeros due to limitations of numerical representation, but they are very close to zeros. Check that the standard deviations are 1 for the first 5 features in xtrain scaled. In a similar way, we can calculate the standard deviation for all features and then display the first rows. The values are close to 1. Question 4. Create a model of logistic regression. The principle of logistic regression is to fit data with an analytical logistic function which has a characteristic S-shape. With this function, we can estimate the probability for a sample to belong to a class, tumoral or normal. In scikit-learn, we import the logistic regression, then we create an instance of a classifier. I propose you to keep the options by default, except for penalty that we can set to none. We don't need to apply a penalty in this example. To train the classifier, we can use our function calculateAccuracy to train the model and to calculate the prediction accuracy. You need to complete the options of the function to precise which data will be used for training and for test. We need to use here the scaled data, xtrain scaled and xtest scaled. If you put here the non-scaled data, xtrain and xtest, instead of xtrain scaled and xtest scaled, the model will still work and will provide the same results. But depending on your data, it may sometimes take more time to converge or even encounter a problem of convergence. The logistic regression is rather sensitive to scaling. It's better to scale the data before. We obtained a perfect result. The accuracy is 100% in the test dataset. In the question 5, you are invited to create a confusion matrix. A confusion matrix is one of common tools to visualize the performance of an algorithm. It is a table where each row represents the instances in an actual class, while each column represents the instances in a predicted class. The confusion matrix is calculated on the test dataset. The performance of an algorithm in machine learning is always estimated in a test dataset. You need here to define which data should be used to create a confusion matrix. We use the data of the test dataset, xtest scaled, and the corresponding real labels, ytest. The confusion matrix is displayed on screen. In y-axis we have the true labels, and in x-axis we display the labels predicted by logistic regression. 101 samples in the test dataset are normal colon tissues, and they were correctly predicted. 100 samples of colon cancer were also correctly predicted. We have here 0 errors of prediction. 0 samples that are tumors but predicted normal, and 0 samples that are actually normal but predicted tumors. The logistic regression performed very well on our data. Question 6. Evaluate the impact of each gene in logistic regression classifier. The logistic regression attributes a coefficient beta to each feature. The greater is the coefficient, the greater is the impact of the corresponding gene in the model. Therefore, by evaluating these coefficients beta, we can find the most predictive genes. let's first display the coefficients beta for some genes. The coefficients are available in the attribute coef of the training classifier. We can see that some coefficients are positive and some others are negative. It depends if the gene is overexpressed in tumors or in normal samples. We can sort the genes by the coefficients and display them in a bar plot. The gene DAO has an important negative coefficient beta. This gene is overexpressed in normal samples. The gene RNF43 has an important positive beta. This gene is overexpressed in tumor samples. The both genes are good predictors because the corresponding absolute values of beta are the highest in the model. What genes have the most important impact in the model? The genes with the biggest absolute value of beta impact mostly the model. For example, the genes DAO, UGP2, SLC7A5, and RNF43. What genes have almost no impact on the prediction? The genes for which the coefficient beta is close to zero have no impact in the model. Select the best three features mostly impacting the model. The code is given, you need to understand the principle and to execute it. First, we define the number of genes that we want to select. Three genes in our case, but you can easily change the number here. In the next line, we calculate the absolute values of beta. We then sort the genes by the absolute values of beta in descending order, the biggest comes the first. Finally, we select the top three genes and display them. The top genes that impact the most our model are RNF43, SLC7A5, and DAO. Question 7. Calculate the performance of logistic regression model using 1, 2, and top features. What does the code below calculate? Execute it and explain the result. It is better to execute first the code and to see the output. The code takes a list of 1, 2, or 3 best genes, trains a classification model using these genes only, and calculates the accuracy of prediction. If we use only the gene RNF43, the prediction accuracy is about 84% in the test dataset. If we use two genes, the prediction is much higher, approximately 94%. For the top three genes, we attain a very good prediction of 99%. So, do we need to use all the 60 genes in the model? We can probably reduce the number of genes. If we select the genes with the most important impact on the model, how many should we keep? In many situations, the accuracy of 99% is already a very good result. In this case, three genes would be sufficient. You can try to increase the number of top genes. Normally, with 6 or 7 genes, you should obtain almost 100% of correct predictions in the test dataset. It means that we don't need the measurements for all the 60 genes to predict the diagnosis. We can select a few of them to obtain a good prediction. This technique of feature selection works if the features are not correlated, at least not highly correlated. If you use it on another dataset, please check the correlation. The last question is a study case. Imagine that a fiction hospital, AI hospital, developed a new diagnosis tool which is able to recognize colon cancer from RNA-seq data. The classification is based on the expression levels of three genes, RNF43, SLC7A5, and DAO. A new patient arrives in the hospital. For this patient, the following gene expression levels are obtained. The gene RNF43 is expressed at the level 4.68, SLC7A5 at 4.10, and DAO at 7.59. The main question you should answer is the following. Does this patient have a colon cancer? In this exercise, you need to train a classification model of logistic regression based on expression levels of three genes. In this situation, you can use a total dataset of colon cancer as a training dataset. Then you can make a prediction for the new patient. In the test dataset, you will have only one sample corresponding to the new patient. You are asked to write the code by yourself. First, you need to scale the data. create a standard scalar, then use the method fit to calculate the means and standard deviations from the training dataset only. After that, scale the training and test datasets using these values with the method transform. Create a logistic regression classifier in the next line. Train it with the fit method on the scaled training dataset. And then you can make a prediction for the new patient using the method predict on the scaled test dataset. Finally, display the result. It appears that the sample of the new patient is a normal colon tissue. Fortunately, the patient doesn't have a colon cancer. I hope this practical session was useful for you. Thank you for following the exercises. I wish you a good day.